taxes eventually. At the moment, it's just looking at VAT, but I'm going to give you a bit of the history in terms of how this developed. But the whole premise behind it is the UK having a really good online tax system where you as individuals can go online, see how your tax is building, and obviously from the revenues point of view, they have up-to-date information, they know who owes what, and if you wish, you'll be able to voluntarily keep your tax up to date so that you might end up paying a little in advance, which obviously is a bit of a benefit for the government. Now, the background to this, in the budget in 2015, it set out its vision, which was great, and it published various papers, which I had fun reading, and basically, a lot of it was really good, but they were pushing it far too fast. So they were looking at bringing in the lower end, so anyone with income over £10,000, reporting quarterly, online, keeping the records digitally, from 2018, which didn't give anyone an awful lot of time to grasp what was happening or to change the way they were doing business. Now, the House of Lords basically turned around and said, hang on folks, you're just going far too fast. So they kicked that into touch and Revenue turned around and said, well, what we'll do is we'll start with businesses that are VAT registered because they're already going online quarterly to file their VAT returns. And we'll tone down a little bit what we're asking people to do. So they won't be reporting quarterly for other taxes, just for VAT, which they're doing already anyway. So there is still behind that the idea that everybody is going to report quarterly eventually, but they're saying now, well, we're not going to apply it to other taxes before 2020. Now you'll have seen this in the news when it first came out. No more tax returns. That was the kind of big publicity behind it when they first came out with this. Because the idea is that you will report quarterly and then you will do an end of year kind of adjustment in order to finalise the tax that's due for that year. And therefore you weren't going to need to do a tax return. But instead of that you're going to be doing four returns and a final adjustment. So, the main strands to these, some of these are already up and running. So the personal tax accounts have already been created by the revenue. So anyone who already pays tax, either as someone who's got rents, or anyone who's got employed, you know, you can register at the government gateway and you can go online and you can see your personal tax account and you can see, specifically with salaries, because of RTI, they now get updated whenever they're filed, so it's all real-time information. At the moment, it's more sort of you looking at it. If you register and you go online and you see your personal tax accounts, you can actually adjust things like notices of coding and things like that. So it's a bit interactive, but obviously that's kind of the start of the future, if you like. This was the original timetable, and you can see the personal tax accounts, they're already there. The consultations have been issued. What's changed is the order, if you like. So the April 2018 quarterly updates for non-VAT registered businesses has now gone. The quarterly updates for VAT registered businesses is still there. And everything else is kind of possibly 2020, but they haven't quite decided yet because it'll depend on how the pilot scheme runs and what actually happens in 2019 when it goes live. Now, this is who it's going to affect. It's all VAT registered businesses who have a turnover of more than 85,000. So, you know, there could be a lot of little businesses that have registered for VAT because they're repayment claims. They won't be affected. It's only those who have to be registered because their taxable turnover is over 85,000. Now what this means is that those businesses have to keep their records digitally from 2019, which is only a year away. They've started the pilot now, and we have lots of businesses that already have digital systems, so Sage, QuickBooks, anything where the records are held in a digital form, are likely to comply. Not all will. VT have already turned around and said that they're not likely to get their software up to speed to comply with what the revenue need, but most accounting systems will. The problem is where you've got businesses who have manual systems. And you know, there are a lot of businesses out there who keep their records in Cashbook and do the VAT quarterly, but they go online to the government gateway and they put the figures in manually. And that's what the revenue are trying to cut out. They want everything kept digitally. And they don't want people going on and putting it in manually, which, because a lot of people, even though they've got Sage or QuickBooks, can work out what the VAT is, but then instead of pressing the button that fires it invisibly to the government gateway, they don't want to do that. So they write it out, and they go on the government gateway, and they put it in manually. And the government really does think that there's a lot of tax being lost through errors because people are doing it manually. Personally, I'm not so sure, because it's garbage in, garbage out. You're not looking after your systems. But it does mean that those people who have perfectly good manual cash books have to change. And it's no good leaving it till 2019 and then trying out a system. You need to be playing around with things now and finding out what's going to suit in order to be ready for that. Obviously, at the moment, that's the timetable. We know from past experience that, you know, 12 months for a pilot's not a lot. And it's only been actually live since this April. So we've got no feedback at the moment at all. The legislation's not completely through Parliament, so things like spreadsheets, they're digital. But how do you get a spreadsheet to connect to the government gateway to feed the figures in without you manually put them in? We haven't got any details on that yet. So whether it actually will be 2019, I don't know, but you might as well work to that. So they're estimating that errors and mistakes contribute to the $9 billion lost annually in tax. And they are pushing this. And I can imagine once it's up and running, and then we go on to the quarterly reporting, that may well cut down on errors, simply because people will have to do it quarterly. There's no point in leaving it. You'll have to be up to date. Now, something that did surprise people is that rents will also fall into this. Like I say, at the moment it's just that from 2019, and if that goes well, they'll look at what comes in 2020. But if you are a landlord, for example, and you've got a property that you let, and maybe you've got your own little business, and maybe you work part-time, you are going to have to go online quarterly, and you are going to have to submit how your business is doing, so whatever income expenses, quarterly. You're also then going to have another form for your rents, and you're going to have to put that in quarterly. So you could end up with several bits that you're doing. So again, it's all up in the air at the moment, but that's the aim, is that the revenue will see what your income is every quarter. You will see how your tax bill is building, because it will give you an estimate of that. And then at the end of the four quarters, you then have your annual adjustment, so stock takes. If you're a farmer, you'll be looking at things like averaging your profits, what your stock was at the end of the year, all those kind of adjustments, prepayments, accruals, all that will be done in this final adjustment. And the vision from the revenues point of view is that these new systems, and they are becoming a lot more intelligent. So their vision is that, you know, you go home, you put your invoices on the table, you photograph them, they will go into your accounting software, they will be recognised, they'll be posted to the appropriate expense code, You'll check it, you'll file your things automatically, quarterly, within the deadlines, because there will be penalties for not filing. And as the systems become more sophisticated, these software programs will give you little nudges. So if, for example, you're a business and you get your petrol from a particular garage and then buy a car there, that the software will go, well, I normally put that to fuel, but this is rather large. Is it something else? Would you like to allocate that to motor cars rather than motor expenses? And you can see in the future, I was reading yesterday about a new system where it's called Counting Up, where someone is developing an accounting program that is actually tied up to your bank account. So you don't need a separate program. You have an online bank account. It knows what payments are, obviously, I think probably not checks, but direct payments coming in. And it will recognise those and allocate them, and it's a combined bank account and accounting software, which is amazing. But you can see that that will then feed through, which is all brilliant, and it sounds amazing, but people have to know what they're doing when they set things up. Otherwise, people are going to be putting odd things in odd places, and it's not going to work the way the revenue think it will. But you can see where they're going with it. Now, these are just some. There are so many software providers out there. As accountants, we deal with any of them, any and all of them. We've all been trained up on QuickBooks because at the moment that seems to be pretty powerful in the marketplace. We've had Sage forever, so we're all pretty clued up on that. We have clients on Xero, Cashflow, not on ClearBooks yet, but we do have potential one on Free Agent at the moment, which is another new one to us. So, you know, there is the provision out there, but it's getting the message out to people that they need to be addressing it now, not leaving it. And obviously, we are offering free sessions to people. Anyone who needs help on getting to grips with any of these programs, we're going to offer free sessions. People come in, make an appointment, come in, have a look at these, see if it's going to work for them, and you know, we can help, basically. There will be some people, I mean, I've got some older clients who don't really want to do this. And if they carry on in business, they're going to have to do something, and you know, in that case, we'll probably end up doing the bookkeeping for them and filing for them. But you know, most people, especially the younger generation, I mean, you can see the next generation coming up, they're going to be doing all their accounts on the phone. it's just the way things are moving. Yeah, so it's kind of exciting and a bit scary at the same time, but very interesting. I don't know if anybody's got any questions about that.